Hi, my name is Ormild and you are listening to the Millennial Perspective Podcast, a podcast that's dedicated to helping you better your life and the lives of people around you. I hope you enjoy this episode of the podcast. Thank you for joining me in this episode of the Millennial Perspective Podcast. In this episode and a few other coming episodes, I will be sharing with you perspectives themed around the series Understanding Leadership. This is because I believe leadership is a good thing to admire, leadership is a good thing to desire, but in order for leadership to benefit both the leader and the people that they lead, leadership must first be understood. In today's episode, we will look at the third and fourth principles that you need to understand in order for you to flourish as a leader. We looked at the first and second principles in the previous episode, so if you haven't yet, please do have a listen to it. The two principles I'm talking about today are the foundation of leadership and the evidence of leadership. Firstly, let's look at the foundation of leadership. I believe the best foundation one or that you should have for leadership is character. This is because character is a vital component of leadership. I like to say that character is to leadership what a foundation is to a house or any building. The same way that a foundation of a building determines how long the building firstly will stand or how much weight it can take on, the same applies to character or to the character that you have when it comes to leadership. Your character will determine how long you stay in leadership, as well as determine the pressures that you can take on as a leader or in the leadership role. You can be the best qualified candidate. You can have all the required professional skills. You can have all the documentations that are needed. But if you have a bad character, I guarantee you, you won't last long in leadership or in that particular leadership role. You might be committed to serving people even. You might be an individual that's committed to, I'm here to serve the people and this is what I want to do. But if you're serving people whilst having a bad attitude, whilst having a bad character, your service won't get highly appreciated and that will work against you. So your character is key to the type of leader you'll become and how people will receive you as a leader. I need you to understand, professional leadership skills are important, right? But they are not as foundational as the character you have. Very controversial statement, some might say. I'm in no way saying that having professional skills is useless or you don't need to have professional skills to be a leader. Professional skills are important, but they should work in partnership with good character. A highly skilled individual, this is why professional skills should work in partnership with good character. A highly skilled individual with bad character will be toxic to the people that they lead. These are the people that you and I be out here calling bad leaders. So if we understand that professional skills, or if we understand that character in some way surpasses professional skills, it is best for you, firstly, to have a good character as a leader, and secondly, to have or pursue the professional skills necessary for you to serve in that leadership role. Let's look at the second principle. The second principle I talked about is, or I'm going to talk about, is the evidence of leadership. And in this case, the evidence of leadership is competence. So every leader must have evidence of their leadership ability. Without evidence, unfortunately, I'll say this, without the evidence of leadership, you are just pretty much a wannabe leader. In the few years that I've been alive, I have been privileged to serve under some pretty great leaders, and unfortunately, under some bad ones as well. The great leaders I have served under were great for many reasons, but one of them is that they had and still have evidence of their leadership, while the bad leaders I served under didn't have the evidence of leadership. I'll put it this way. Competence is evidence of your leadership ability. Your ability to do something successfully and efficiently definitely sets you apart from other people, whether you are a leader or not. Competence will also position you for leadership. So if you are a leader, or if you are pursuing being a leader, ensure that you are competent in whatever you do. Now, you can be motivated by love. You can be ready to serve and have a good character. But without competence, without the evidence of leadership, your leadership efforts with time tend to become void or pretty much useless, because you keep on doing things and you're not producing results. That tends to make you an incompetent leader or an incompetent individual, or an individual without the evidence of what you are doing. And this is where professional skills come in very handy. Previously, I'm talking about the character. Now, with the evidence, you need the professional skills. Every leader must have the skills necessary for them to serve the people or the organization that they work for. If you occupy a leadership role without the necessary skills, you become what people like to call a fraud. Now, some people have been fortunate enough to get into roles they don't have the skills for, or that they don't qualify for. This is good, but if you are that individual, you shouldn't stay unskilled for as long as you serve in that role. You might be fortunate enough to get into a role that you do not qualify for, but it is not right or noble for you to stay in that role still unqualified. So if you get into a role that you're not qualified for, utilize your extra or your spare time to equip yourself with the professional or with the skills necessary for you to serve the people, or for you to serve the organization that you're serving. And as you pursue leadership, it's important that you pursue the skills necessary for the role or position of leadership you're pursuing. Competence, I guarantee you, competence will distinguish you. So pursue it. That's pretty much it for today's episode. Two takeaways that I have for you for this episode is, firstly, develop a good character as a leader. Have a good character. Have a character that's likable, that's relatable, that's lovable. And secondly, be competent, or pursue competence in your leadership capacity. Get the skills necessary for you to do the work that you need to do. Thank you so much for listening. My name is Ormild, and you've been listening to the Millennial Perspective Podcast. Enjoy yourself.